Safdarjung Tomb Complex has only one double-storied entrance located on the east, which by all means is befitting to this great specimen of late Mughal architecture. The raised central bay is built of red sandstone, ornamented with late Mughal architecture features and roofed by an open loggia of three bays. The rest of the structure is extremely finished in plaster. The central bay leads into a domed chamber surrounded by smaller apartments on both the upper and the lower stories. The facade of the central bay was lavishly painted, originally of which traces could still be seen under the main entrance arch. Safdarjung Tomb was built in 1753-54 CE by Nawab Shuja-ud-Daula as a tribute to his father memory Mirza Abul Mansur Khan, entitled Safdarjung. He was the governor of province of Awadh under the reign of Muhammad Shah, 1719-48 CE, the Mughal ruler and the later his prime minister. The monument is entered through an ornamented painted gateway on the east. This double-storied gateway has several apartments, a courtyard, and a mosque. The enclosure walls with the channels over them to carry water to different pavilions contain series of recessed arches on the interior and octagonal towers on the four corners. It has multi-chambered pavilion, namely Moti Mahal, Pearl Palace, Badshah Pasand, King's Favorite, and Jungli Mahal, Selvi Palace on the north, south, and west respectively. The garden is divided into four square of side pathways and a tank, which are again divided into smaller square and a pathways on the char bag pattern. The double-storied mausoleum measures 18.29 into 18.29 meters square, built with red and buff sandstone, relieved by marble stands in the center of a garden, and rises from a high platform. The platform has a number of cells beneath it. The structure has a central chamber surrounded by eight apartments around it. The corners of the tomb is occupied by polygonal towers, and the bulbous dome rises from a 16th-sided drum. The marble and the sandstone for this structure was removed from the tomb of Abdur Rahim Khan A. Khanan. The tomb is described as the last flicker in the dying lamp of Mughal architecture, Delhi. This is the scanning QR code with which you can book your tickets instantly from the government portal. You can also get discount also depending on the number of tickets you book, and you can jump from the queue by booking it and getting a digital copy of the ticket. All you need to do is select nationality, number of tickets, and enter the mobile number. Proceed and make the payment. Get tickets on mobile. Ticket would be valid for the date that you register. Also, you can register while coming to the monument from the as eyesight, selecting the city, the monument you want to visit, and the date and time of the visit. The site will load depending on the speed of your internet, and once it loads, then you have to just click the next arrow button, which will be showing just in a few minutes. Now you select the date on which you want to visit, can be the current date or the next date in the future. Then the visiting time, forenoon, afternoon, evening. And it will show you how many tickets are available at that point of the day. Now just click the next arrow button on the screen. And here you will see enter details in which you have to select your nationality, foreigner, from a SAARC country, from BIMSTEC country. All these options will have different values. And in the adult, you have to select how many adults are there, adult 1, 2, 3. And in the select ID, you have passport, PAN card, driving license as an option, voter ID. And all you need to do is manually enter the details and the email ID in which you will get your digital ticket also. Select the number of people coming to visit the monument, and you can see the values will change depending on which nationality you select. Once you do this, you will get a download the e-ticket, and the same will be shared on your email ID provided. The tomb is located near the Safdarjung Airport at the T junction of Lodi Road and Aurobindo Marg, earlier named Mehrauli Road, in New Delhi. Safdarjung Tomb is a sandstone and a marble mausoleum in Delhi, India. Located in the central position of the enclosed Mughal garden, this double-storied imposing mausoleum raised on 3.048 meter or 10 feet high podium from the level of garden has four entrances from all four sides provided with covered stairways. Faced with spacious veranda, the central chamber covers about 6.096 meter about 20 feet square and retains highly polished and intricately carved marble cenotaph, which is entered through an arched opening having an Arabic inscription on the top. The ceiling of central chamber is profusely ornamented with incised geometrical and floral design in plaster. The chamber possesses 8 cells or apartments around the walls of which are made of marble up to the waist. The 4 corner apartments are octagonal having red sandstone ceiling with an inverted lotus design in the center, and the 4 rectangular apartments reveal ornamented ceiling in plaster equipped with floral and geometrical designs. The buildings over the grave attains a height of about 27.43 meters, 90 feet, capped by a central dome. This large dome with its bulbous outline rises from a 16-sided drum which resembles Persian prototypes. It is further topped by a deep finial base of usual lotus pattern supporting a marble pinnacle. The corner of the main tomb are occupied by polygonal turrets, towers, decorated with inlaid design in marble and sandstone, covered by chhatris, each provided with a miniature dome. The underground chamber contains 2 graves in the center covered with earthen molds, possibly one of the Safdarjung and the other of his wife, Khujista Banu Begum. The entrance to the tomb chamber from all the four sides are located within high recessed engrailed arches. It was built in 1754 in the late Mughal Empire style for Nawab Safdarjung. The monument has an ambience of spaciousness and an imposing presence with its domed and arched red, brown and white colored structures. Mirza Muqim Abul Mansur Khan, who was popularly known as Safdarjung, who ruled over Awadh, was an independent ruler of Awadh as a viceroy of Muhammad Shah. He was very rich and most powerful. With the death of Emperor Muhammad Shah of Mughal Empire, he moved to Delhi. When Ahmad Shah ascended the throne of the Mughal Empire in Delhi in 1748, Safdarjung was made the Prime Minister, Wazir, of the Empire with the title of Wazir ul Mamlik e Hindustan. And at that time, the emperor was on decline as their rule extended only to North India. As Wazir, he usurped all power under his control, as the king was only a puppet, a figurehead, who was enjoying life with wine, opium, and women. But his control over the empire's family was so cruel that the emperor called the Marathas to rid of their wazir. The Maratha drove Safdarjung out of Delhi in 1753. He died soon thereafter in 1754. After his death, his son Nawab Shujaat Daulah pleaded with the Mughal emperor to permit him to erect a tomb for his father in Delhi. He then built the tomb, which was designed by Abyssinian architect. It was built by Bilal Muhammad Khan at the cost of 3 lakhs of rupees. The Safdarjung tomb, the last monumental tomb garden of the Mughals, was planned and built like an enclosed garden tomb in line with the style of Humayun tomb. It was completed in 1754. The slab from the tomb of Abdul Rahim Khankhan were used in the construction of the tomb. The tomb has 4 key features, which are the Charbagh plan with the mausoleum at the center, a 9-fold floor plan, a 5-part facade and large podium with a hidden stairway. The main entry gate to the tomb is 2-storied and is
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.
क्या कुछ नहीं है? हाँ हाँ ये
स्कूल का जब छुट्टी नहीं है तो ट्यूशन भी क्या देते हैं?
Thank you.